Hello friends, welcome to my channel Civil Structures. In this video, we'll see how to design shear reinforcement in a beam. Okay, so let's first see steps to design shear reinforcement. Our first step will be to calculate shear force in particular beam. We can notify shear force as Vu. Now, how to calculate shear force in a beam? Let me show you. Let's say this is one beam subjected with UDL. Now, let's draw the shear force diagram. And we know that here the shear force will be maximum at the support. So, we have to calculate this particular Vu max. Okay. Then step number two, to calculate nominal shear stress is tau V. The formula for tau V is Vu upon Pd, where your Vu is shear force, or we can say maximum shear force in the beam. B is equal to width of beam and D as in effective depth of beam. You can find this formula in clause number 40 for IS 456 2000. Now our step number 3 is to calculate tau c. This tau c is depending upon the percentage of reinforcement provided in beam. Now how you can calculate this percentage of reinforcement? We have a formula, 100 AST upon BD. We know what is AST, area of reinforcement provided. Then B and D will be similar as I have shown you here. The B is the width of beam and D is an effective depth of beam. Okay. Now, our fourth step is to compare this tau V and tau C. So, if our tau V is less than tau C, then no requirement of shear stress reinforcement. Still, we can provide nominal shear reinforcement. To provide nominal shear reinforcement, we have a formula, ASV upon B into SV. It should be more than equal to 0.487 Fy. This formula you can find in clause number 26.5.1.6. As we know the code IS 456 2000. Okay, now what is this ASV suggest? ASV as in area of shear reinforcement we provided. B, we know that the width of the beam. Now what is SV? SV is a spacing between the shear reinforcement. And we know the Fy, yield strength of the steel. Okay, now let me tell you how to calculate this SV. We have a formula for SV given in IS 456. It is 0.87 Fy ASV upon 0.4B. Okay, so with the help of SV, you can calculate your spacing of stirrups, or we can say the spacing of shear reinforcement. Now our next step, if our tau E is more than tau C, then we have to provide shear reinforcement, or we can say the shear reinforcement calculation is required. For that, first of all, we have to calculate VUS. The formula for VUS is VU. We know that what is VU, as in maximum shear force in particular element, minus tau C. We have calculated from table number 19 as per IS 456-2000, and it depends upon the percentage of reinforcement and the formula. Let me complete. Tau C BD. Okay, we know the B, width of the beam, and D is in effective depth of the beam. After that, we have to calculate the spacing of the shear reinforcement, and the formula for that, 0.87 Fy ASV into D upon VUS. And how we calculate our spacing of shear reinforcement? Here, what is ASV? Here, ASV is area of reinforcement we have provided. Now, we have some rules regarding the spacing of the shear reinforcement. Rule number one, your spacing should be 0.75 D. D as in effective depth. The case number two, or we can say condition number two, it should be 300 mm. And the condition number 3, 0.87 Fy ASV upon 0.4 B. So this formula, I think you can recognize, this is a formula for SV for nominal. Okay, and the last one, whatever we calculated SV for provided shear reinforcement. So we have to check these all four conditions, and we should provide spacing least of these four. That will be our provided spacing of the shear reinforcement. Now let's solve some examples to design shear reinforcement in beam. Let me take first example. A simply supported singly RCC beam having 250 mm width and 450 mm effective depth, which is subjected to 50 kN per meter at working load. The beam is reinforced with four numbers 18 mm bar diameter. The clear span of the beam is 6 meter. The design of shear reinforcement for the beam. Here you can use M20. You can see this beam is already designed with main reinforcement. We have to design the shear reinforcement. For that, we have to check whether the shear reinforcement calculation is required or not. Okay, so let's take, I'm showing you first the longitudinal section of this particular beam. Okay, and it is designed with main reinforcement. You can see the main reinforcement in cross section. Okay, so let me first show you the dimensions. The length is 6 meter of this particular beam. Then the width is 250 mm and the depth is 450 mm. Sorry, this is the effective depth. Okay. Now, we have to design the shear reinforcement. Okay, so for that, our first step to determine shear reinforcement, our first step is to calculate VU. And how we determine VU? As you can see, there is a beam. The load is 50 kilonewton per meter. It is a simply supported beam, span having 6 meter. Okay, now let's draw the shear force diagram here. It is UDL. The shear force diagram will be something like this, and you can determine here VU max. So what is the formula to determine VU max when it is subjected with UDL? It is WU into L upon 2. So what is your WU? WU is UDL at working load. Sorry, at factored load. Okay, so how will you calculate VU? It is 50 kilonewton per meter multiplied by 1.5. So now let's calculate 50 multiplied by 1. It is 75 kilonewton per meter. Okay, now let's calculate VU max. 75 multiplied by 6000. I'm taking 6 meter only because 75, it is also in meter, 75 kilonewton per meter. It is divided by 2. So my calculation will be 75 multiplied by 6 divided by 2. It is 225 kilonewton. Okay. Now after the calculation of VU, it is 225 kilonewton. We have to determine tau V. And formula for tau V is VU upon BD. So VU is 225. I'm taking in Newton now. So this is in multiplied by 10 raised to 3. Your B is 250 multiplied by 450. And your tau V is 2 Newton per mm square. As you can see, I'm taking this both values in mm. Okay. Now our next step is to calculate tau C. Now how you can calculate tau C? It depends upon percentage of reinforcement. So first of all, we have to calculate PT. Okay, before calculation of PT, we have to calculate AST. Okay, then AST is given us that 4 number of bars, 18 mm diameter. So our AST will be 1018 mm square. How to calculate PT? The formula is 100 AST upon BD. Sorry, 250 multiplied by 450. So your PT, the value is 0.9%. Okay, now as per the table 19 in IS 456-2000, we have to determine tau C. But as you can see in the table number 19, we cannot take tau C directly. Okay, to calculate tau C, we have to interpolation between tau C and PT. You can see it also depends on the grade of concrete. Let's see how our grade of concrete is here, 20. Okay, now let's calculate tau C. So after my interpolation, the value of tau C is 0.596 Newton per mm square. Now we have to compare between our tau E and tau C. And you can see here, our tau C is more than tau C, so the calculation of shear reinforcement is required. Now for the calculation of shear reinforcement, our first step is to calculate VUS, the ultimate shear strain capacity. The formula for VUS is VU minus tau C BD. So the value of VU is 225 into 10 raised to 3 minus tau C is 0.596 multiplied by 250 multiplied by 450, and the answer is 157,950 in Newton. Okay, now we have to assume our ASV, that we have to take two-legged stirrups, 8 mm bar dia, and we can calculate our ASV as in pi by 4 8 square 8 for the diameter of bar, and if it is two-legged we have to multiply with the 2. The form the value of ASV will be 100.5 mm square. Now let's calculate SV, 0.87 FY ASV into D upon VUS. With this formula we can calculate our spacing between the stirrups. The value is 103 mm. Now we have to check the spacing of the shear reinforcement as per these four conditions. Okay, so our first condition is 0.75 D. So let's calculate. The value of D is 450 mm. Okay, after calculation I am getting the value 337 mm. Second condition is 300 mm. The third condition is the nominal spacing of shear reinforcement. After putting all the values and we can calculate, the SV is 362 mm. In our fourth condition, what we have calculated earlier with this formula SV, it is 103 mm. Again, we have to take list from this 4. So which value is list? You can see it is 103 mm. Okay, so I can tell you that we have to provide shear reinforcement, provide two-legged stirrups at 8 mm bar dia at 100 mm center to center. As you can see, our spacing value we get here 103, so we could not provide every time 103 103, so let's take round off. And for the round off value for shear reinforcement, always take the below one, as in whichever is lesser from the calculated value, whichever lesser rounded value. So here our round off value of 103 is 100 mm, so it will, we have to provide spacing 100 mm center to center. Now let's draw the reinforcement here. Okay, as you can see this. Now we have to provide two anchorage bars, and our shear reinforcement will be 1 along the longitudinal dimension of the beam. Okay, and you can see particular this distance is SV, as in here 100 mm. Okay, so this is how we can do our reinforcement in beam. Now let's take second example. A simply supported singly RCC beam, 250 mm width and 450 mm effective depth. The beam is reinforced with
four number of 22 mm bar diameters. The beam is subjected to shear force 45 kN at factored load. The design shear reinforcement for the beam, here you can use M20 concrete and HOSD steel bars.
Now let's discuss the given data of this particular example. Okay, so they have given us the size of the beam, width is 250 mm, the effective depth is 400 mm. Okay, then reinforcement already provided with four number of 22 mm bar diameters. We can use M20 grade of concrete and Fe415 as in grade of steel. Okay, now we have to determine we have to determine the shear reinforcement of this particular beam. So let me first draw the cross section of this particular beam, as we have not given here the length of the beam, so we don't know how to draw the longitudinal dimension of the beam. So let's draw the cross section here, and in cross section they have mentioned width, effective depth, 4 bars of 22 mm bar diameter. Okay, so what is the complete AST here? So if I calculate the AST, it is pi by 4, 22 square multiply by 4 number. So AST will be 1520.5 mm square. In example, they have already given us the factored shear force, as in we can denote as VU. The value of VU already given to us is 45 kN. As they already given with the factored shear force, we don't have to multiply with 1.5, which is a factored value. Okay. So for the calculation, we can directly start with our example tau V. For tau V, VU upon BD, our value will be 45 into 10 raised to 3 in Newton. B is 250 multiplied by 400, and the value of tau V we calculate here is 0.45. Newton per mm square. As you can see, I have taken B and D both in mm. So the unit for the tau V is 0.45 Newton per mm square. Now we have to calculate tau C. Before calculation of tau C, it depends upon PT. So we have to calculate PT here. How to calculate PT? PT is depend upon the AST. So the formula for PT, 100 AST upon BD. Okay, so the PT will be 1.5%, and the value of tau C as per the table number 19, we can calculate tau C is 0.72 Newton per shear reinforcement. Okay, first of all, let's take two-legged 8 mm bar dia stirrups. We have to assume this first, and as per this assumption, we can calculate with our ASV here. It is pi by 4 8 square multiplied by 2, and it is 100.5 mm square. Then we should calculate SV, 0.87 FY ASV upon 0.4 B, and after putting all the values, value of SV is 218 mm. So as I say, we cannot provide 218 mm spacing every after every stirrups. Okay, so we have to make this figure round. And as I say, you do always least round of value. So the round of value least will be 210 mm. Okay, now we have to check for the spacing. For the check for the spacing, we have to do three conditions. First condition is 0.75D and the value will be 300 mm. Second condition is 300 mm itself. And our third condition is SV. We already calculated for the nominal reinforcement. It is 210 mm. So it is 210 mm, which is the least value here. It is also 210 mm. So we can say provide 8 mm bar diameter stirrups at 210 mm center to center.